Iron Monk is about a monk that is forced to do things against his own beliefs. His life is about teaching the Buddhist philosophy. He lives for peace. There is a story about a monk, when he died, he was offered a chance to go to heaven. And he asked if it's okay if he could go to hell. He was then asked, why would you want to do that? Why would you want to go to hell? You have done everything right. You deserve to be in heaven. And he replied, because in hell, I can help more people.
Today is the trailer day. We are shooting the very first time we've come together, and we're putting together our trailer for Iron Monk, the movie.
Iron Monk is the tale of a Shaolin temple that falls prey to a group of triads, and eventually the head of the temple is forced to fight back.
The film is set in London, in Chinatown, right now. We imagine there's a Shaolin temple in Chinatown, and it's the monk is there, happy with his life, slowly enlightening people. Now, the problem with that is that he's so good at it that it's bad for business, for the triad. The triad rely on drugs, prostitution, everything else. And because he's having such a positive impact on the community, it's causing them problems, basically.
When I first had this idea for this action movie, I first approached my longtime friend, Si Yanjie. He's a Shaolin monk. He's the 34th generation Shaolin monk.
In addition to all of the incredible kung fu people that are on the film, there's a real philosophical heart. And that's Yanjie, who is the monk, who is a real monk, 34th generation, who also plays the Iron Monk character.
The reason to make Iron Monk this film, I think I come here to promote the Shaolin culture, so always try to think find a chance and try to think a way to promote the Shaolin culture as much as I can, so I use all my lifetime.
Well, the thing that really is key for Jason and the whole team really is to strip it right back, to get back to the simplest kind of Bruce Lee form of Kung Fu.
In a way, I want the Kung Fu to be going back to basic. I basically want to recreate the genre, create a film that actually uses real fighter. We will use real fighter, expert stuntman. We will not use wire, no CGI.
In the trailer, you saw that my students demo the iron jacket, iron legs. So they use the iron brush to hit themselves, do the real qigong training. And they use the stick. We use a stick to break on the stomach and the legs. So all this is a real. On the camera, you can see, yeah, the stick is not, it's a real. It can't be fake. Yeah, and also they are real Kung Fu students.
As a director and a viewer, I've always loved Kung Fu. I love the action. I love the style. I love the speed. And I love the excitement of that genre.
So to achieve this, you would first need to have an action director that would understand how a fight scene would look on camera in a movie. And with Vincent, he being a Wushu master, he understands the form, he understands Kung Fu from the root down. At the same time, he understands how it looks in front of the camera, how to, not just to punch, but he understands how to fall.
Pure fighting doesn't translate as well to film. So one of the challenges was to make that stand out, which was what Vincent did. He created a fight that would show off those skills and make them look exciting on film. The temple fight's a hugely complicated fight scene. It's got seven fighters on one side, versus the Iron Monk. Gives the Iron Monk a chance to really show off his power and his abilities and his fighting styles?
We wanted to have a scene to kind of establish the Iron Monk, our hero character. How can we show him powerful, that he can take down a group of tribe? Instead of showing the Iron Monk getting beat up, breaking woods, breaking metal in his head, by showing the student breaking the wood with their own fist or with their legs or with their stomach, we were able to show the power of his student, hence the power of the master himself, without actually showing that.
The boxing ring scene is a very different fight scene from the temple scene. We wanted to create something where it was all about violence, and it was all about anger, and it was all about showing off. It was all about the egos of the triads. So Tommy Chan visits the boxing ring to lay down the law. I am here, and if you don't like it, this is what is going to happen to you. You're going to die.
Where Iron Monk sits, I think, in terms of British film, is it's not a London gangster, Danny Dyer, Guy Ritchie kind of a film. And I think that the reason it's different from that is that we have this very strong Oriental influence. It's Chinatown, it could be happening, there's real people with real thoughts. The other thing for me that's very important is our attitude to violence, why they're fighting in the first place. So sometimes with these gangster movies, it's like comedy violence, like torture porn, or this kind of excessively gratuitous violence. Whereas for us, I think it's because of this Zen influence about why does a Buddhist monk who's a peaceful guy, why does he fight? In a way, when you see Yanzi do his moves, he's not all over the place, out of control, going nuts. He's really fighting for a reason. It's all very under control. So I think it's a very fresh take on a kind of a familiar genre, but it's really new and exciting. There's an incredible amount of talent here. It's mind-blowing, really. Films like Inception, James Bond films, Dark Knight, Harry Potter. It's all there, and everyone has been brought on because they're so passionate about the project.
For me, it has always been a dream to kind of like making a kung fu movie, and I always wanted to make it with Xie Yanzi. I love Bruce Lee movie, those 70 classic, wonderful action movie that I grew up and love so much. And I dream to work and make my own film one day. So doing this project, Iron Monk, it has been a dream come true for me.
Iron Monk is going to be a great kung fu film, but it's going to be a great kung fu film with a British style to it. It's going to have humor, it's going to have no wires, it's going to have no CG, it's going to have full contact, and it's going to kick ass.